Welcome back. Usually CommVault administrators tend to jump into troubleshooting issues the moment they see the error code. We would recommend performing the basic checks before you dive in troubleshooting. In this video we will discuss the basic troubleshooting checks which might solve many issues. In CommCell Browser. Under Client Computers. Select the client in question. Right click, and select Properties. Client Computer Properties window. General tab. Client name. Could be any name given to easily identify the client. Host name. Is the fully qualified domain name, in other words, FQDN. It should be able to resolve to an IP. You can perform NS lookup to see if IP resolve into proper FQDN, and vice versa. If there are issues, then you need to investigate DNS. Or host file entry, whichever is configured or used in your environment. If your environment has production IP and backup IP, then ensure the IP used here should be backup IP. CommServe host name is the fully qualified domain name of the CommServe. You can change the entries by clicking on Edit. Version tab gives the CommVault version information that is installed on the client server. On the very top you see the install directory, the path shown here is where CommVault software installed on the client. Please pay attention under Service Pack section. If you see there are missing updates, then first install the missing updates, and that might help resolve your issue. Or, if the version of Service Pack is lower than the CommVault version, then please first update the client with the version equal to CommServe. Under Update Status. If you see, needs update, then that means some agent-specific updates or hotfixes are missing, which needs to be installed. Activity Control tab, we need to ensure all three options, Enable Backup, Enable Restore, and Enable Data Aging, are enabled for backup, recovery, and aging operations to run as expected. Click on Advanced to view more options. You can resize the window by dragging the corners of with window, in, or out. Advanced Client Properties. General tab. You can view the port number configured for CVD process. Ideally you see default port 8400, unless configured otherwise. If IntelliSnap is configured then you see the related settings here. Policies tab will show you if any subclient policy set. Job configuration tab. Job priority show the default job priority set for the client. You can change the job priority for the client. It means you can get this client jobs to run with high priority than others by lowering the value from default 6. Job results directory path is by default point to drive C, unless configured otherwise. This is the location where job related information is stored, including collect files. You can change the location of job results directory from here. This is a good option when you see the job results directory is running out of space, and you wish to change the location to another drive. Prune job results after shows the default retention of 7 days. Which can be altered as per requirement. Ensure you keep one cycle data, that is, one full and 6 incremental worth data, to be stored in job results directory, or else you will face issues with backup, converting to full. Data interface pairs, DIP, is created to bind the communication between client and media agent, or client and CommServe, over IP instead of FQDN. Encryption tab shows if there is encryption set for the client data as per customer requirement. It can be set to use storage policy settings or encrypt data using various options shown here. Or do not encrypt data. Additional settings are CommVault related registry keys that can be added from here instead of logging on to server. This is handy when we do not have access to client machine. Click Add to see a lot of registry keys available which are approved by CommVault and can be added when needed. Deduplication tab. The options shown here are related to client-side deduplication. By default, Use Storage Policy Settings is selected. You can perform client-side deduplication by enabling client-side disk cache. By default, maximum 4GB limit is set for disk cache, but you can increase it depending upon the amount of data that is being backup. Please note, the space is used on the drive where CommVault software is installed. Enable high latency optimization. If you see latency in communication, example, one connectivity, you can also choose to disable client-side deduplication. Variable content alignment is a content-aware approach to deduplication that further reduces the amount of data stored during backups. This may be more effective for certain database backups. KPIs tab, you can exclude the client from SLA and strike counts. In a scenario where the client backups are having issues and are affecting the agreed SLAs. Network properties, configure network root settings. In other words, firewall. You will be able to configure one-way firewall or two-way firewall between client, media agent, and CommServe. Network throttle tab, you can enable network throttling if the network bandwidth is limited. You can set percent of network bandwidth to use. That is percent of bandwidth used during business hours and percent of bandwidth used during non-business hours. This is particularly useful for one connectivity or if the client server has 1 or 2 grams bps link speed. Summary tab shows the overall firewall settings configured for this client.